Welcome to Maths with Bob. Today we are looking at parameters and in particular something called the parametric parabola. I guess we should start at what is a parameter. Okay, so let's actually have a quick look. Okay, what is a parameter? A parameter is an introduced variable. Okay, it can have any sort of, you can actually use any variable you like. Common ones are t, p, and q, and theta. Now, the parameters themselves can actually have physical meanings, like, for instance, angles, sometimes with thetas, and t sometimes can be represents time. So sometimes the parameters can have actually physical meanings, but sometimes they don't have physical meanings, and sometimes they are just, they have geometric meanings. Okay. Now, in the parametric parabola, the t actually has a geometric meaning. Okay. So the first thing is, a parameter, okay, is an introduced variable. Which one are we going to use for the parametric parabola? We're going to use t. Okay, so we're going to use t. So what happens with the parabola, and how does it get parametricized, or you can actually break it up into parametric equations? Well, the first thing is, if you actually get a parabola and you deconstructed. I think of it like deconstructing the actual curve itself into its individual points, and you can do this with the aid of a parameter. Okay, in this case t, as I was saying. So let's actually have a look. Suppose I had x and I made that 2t, and I made y equal t squared. Okay. Now, think to yourself, this is interesting. What curve does that represent? Okay, the parameter t actually usually takes on increasing values, so you could start anywhere, like minus 2, and then work out the value of x and y, and then put in, minus 1, and then work out the x and y values at minus 1, and then you can start to plot these points and to see what actually curve has been actually, if you like, deconstructed into these two parametric coordinates, x and y, with the parameter in this case being t. Now, but the easiest way usually is to do this is to eliminate the value of t. So let's actually just have a quick look. Let's actually eliminate the t. So we know that what t would be equal to x over 2. And we know that y is equal to t squared. So therefore, okay, y is equal to x on 2 all squared. Okay, which you can see here is what, x squared on 4. Therefore, x squared equals 4y. So this is now, or if you like, another way of saying that is y is actually a quarter of x squared. So that is, if you like, the curve which had been deconstructed into those two parametric points, the x point, which is a function of t, and the y point, which is a function of t. Well, y equals a quarter x squared. Now, okay, sometimes they actually put an a in here, so let's actually do this with an a. Okay, let's actually make the rubber a bit bigger. So let's actually do this with an a. Okay, so say x is equal to 2at, a is just a constant, and y equals at squared. Now you might think to yourself, why in the world do they put an a in here? Well, let's actually just go through this again and have a look. You can see here, t is equal to what, x on 2a. You can see here, therefore, y is equal to at squared, x on 2a all squared, which you can notice, obviously, it just becomes what? Ax squared on 4a squared, cancel one of the a's, and therefore, okay, x squared equals 4ay. Now, you may remember this. This is actually the locus definition of a point which moves equidistant from a fixed point called the focus and a fixed line called the directrix. Now, the reason they put the a in here, because a is actually the focal length. So when I actually have a parabola, I can actually quite easily work out where the focus is and where the directrix is. Okay, so this is why we usually, deconstruct x squared equals 4ay into 2at and at squared. Okay, so let's have a look now, get a bit of a feeling for, say, the parameter t. So let's actually just, again, make a 1 in this case. So, let's make the focal length 1. Okay, so let's actually have a quick look now. Let's actually just do this. So let's go back to our original equation. Parabola. Okay, x equals 2t and y equals t squared. And you might remember this gave us x squared equals 4y. Or if you like, y is equal to 1/4 x squared. And we know basically from our Locus work that actually the focal length is actually 1 in this case. Okay, so let's get a bit of a feeling for this. Okay, so what I suggest everyone does is this, that just to get a bit of a feeling for parameters, you always just draw up a little ordered pair box. We're going to do x, y, and we should actually add another column, actually, for t. Let's actually make this one the parameter t at the front. And let's have a look at x now as a function of t and y as a function of t. And let's actually just work out some values. So let's put in minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, and 2. Okay, just increase our values of this parameter t and see what happens. Well, obviously, the x value is 2 times, so it's minus 4. What? Is that right? Yes, and how about minus 1? 2 times minus 1, minus 2, 2 zeros are 0. How about 2 ones are 2, and 2 twos are 4? Okay, that's just putting the t's into the x, 2 times t. Now, y t? Y, actually, we have to square the parameter now, so it's going to be what? 4, 1, 0, 1 squared is 1, and 2 squared is 4. Okay, so basically we have a situation like this, and let's actually now just draw up the situation, join the points. Okay, so we know this would be the y, this is the x. So let's actually start plotting some points, say minus 2, 1, 2, say 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 4 here. This is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 0, okay, 1, 2, and let's just plot some points. Okay, minus 2, t value of minus 2 is actually the point minus 4, 4, okay, need to go a bit more, minus 4, okay. Minus 3. Let's go a bit more. Okay, all right, so let's have a look. Minus 4, 4. Okay, all right, so let's just plot that point. Okay. Minus 2, 1. Minus 2, 1 here. 0, 0, yes. 2, x is 2, up to 1. Okay. And out at 4, 4. Okay, so up here somewhere. Okay. So you can see what's happening is that obviously when we join all these points, we get this parabola, y equals 1/4 x squared. Okay, so let's actually just join these points. Here we go. But what is important, I think, is to actually just take a note. What happened over here? Well, t was actually equal to minus 2 here. T was equal to 1, or minus 1 here, I should say. T is equal to 0 here. T was equal to 1 here, and t was equal to 2 here. And sometimes people actually put directions on the curve. Okay, so there's actually an idea that we do increase the value of the parameter, and we keep generating points on this particular curve. Okay, so this is just getting a bit of a feel. So if you like, if, for instance, say, let's have a quick look over here. Okay, over there. What happened over there? Well, the parameter value was minus 2. And to get its x-coordinate, at that particular point, I had to double the parameter, so it's minus 4. So if you have a quick look down, there should be minus 4. You might be able to just see that. And the y-value is t squared, so I had to square that value. Minus 2 squared is 4. So it's actually that parameter is, if you like, reconstructing a point on the curve at minus 4, 4. Or, if you like, that particular point was deconstructed into its parametric values, x is equal to 2t and y is equal to t squared. And it can be found by putting a value of minus 2 in for that parameter. Okay. All right, so this is the first thing. Get a bit of a feel for what parameters are and substitute them in. Now, obviously, this is normally two-dimensional, but you can actually do parameters in three dimensions and all sorts of different things. Sometimes the parameters actually, the case of displacement and velocity, you can actually use t as time and look at how particular particles are moving with respect to time. Okay, so let's now have a look at what does this actually mean, okay, this parameter t. What we're going to find, I'll just show you what we are going to find, is that in fact the slope of the curve at a particular point, say over here at 2, so in fact if I actually draw a tangent to the curve here, its slope is 2. If I draw one here, its slope is 1. Okay, if I draw a tangent over here, m equals minus 2, etc. And so, in fact, the value of the parameter at a particular point is, in fact, equivalent to the slope of the curve at the point. How in the world do we actually prove that? Well, we actually need to take the derivative, and let's actually do that now, too. So let's actually just have a quick look. Actually, I might have to rewrite that now. Okay, but let's actually have a look. Okay, so how would we do that? Well, we know x is equal to 2t and y is equal to t squared. Now, I can actually do a bit of a trick here. I can say, okay, well, I just want to find dy dx at the point. So I can actually say, well, what's dy dx? Well, it's dy dt by dt dx. Okay, so what's that? What's dy dt? And what's dt dx? Well, what's x? What's dx dt? Well, hopefully we can see this is 2. And how about dy dt? We should be able to see that's actually just 2t. So let's actually just do this. Okay, what's dy dt? Dy dt is 2t. How about dt dx? Well, that's the reciprocal of dx dt. Okay, so dt dx, you can see here, is just 1 over 2. Okay, reciprocal, 1 over 2, and hopefully you can see, okay, yes, t. Okay, fantastic. So, if you like, dy dx at the point, 2t t squared is actually t. I could also do this another way. The other way is if you have a look at the curve, let's actually do it the other way. That's a parametric way. Let's actually do it the other way. Okay, so let's do it the other way. Which is, well, most of the time when we differentiate, say we have the curve, we know the curve is called y is equal to 1 quarter x squared, and we know that, okay, dy dx is equal to, what's that, 2 times a quarter times x to the power of x, okay, which is just a half of x. Okay, that's y dash dy dx. And we want to evaluate dy dx at, say, at the point, obviously the x point, so dy dx is now going to be evaluated at the x point 2t. And we know this is equal to a half of x. And what is the x value? It's a half of 2t. It's supposed to be times 2t, and these cancel, and again, they give us t. So t is, if you like, the slope of the tangent, or if you like, the slope of the curve, which in this case is y equals a quarter x squared, at that particular point x is equal to 2t. So it doesn't matter what value we're at, we always will actually have a look at the parameter value that will actually give us the slope of the curve of the point. So it actually does have a geometric meaning in this particular case.